An employee of the House of Representatives is said to be among the country's COVID-19 fatalities. Let's get more details from PBA Party List Representative Jericho Nograles. He is on the line. Good afternoon, Congressman Nograles, and thanks a lot for talking to us.
Good afternoon, Stanley. I am confirming that the House of Representatives received news that one of our employees in his early 40s passed away at 1:45 a.m. earlier today, and he was a confirmed case of COVID-19, which makes it 8 fatalities out of 111 cases, and we are looking at a percentage of 7.2% mortality rate in the Philippines, which is skewed upwards mainly because we don't have enough testing kits.
Yeah.
Just recently, the FDA has released a statement stating that there is no single approved or single FDA-approved testing kit in the country except for those that were donated by the World Health Organization. And with that, I think that is the source of our problem right now. We don't have effective mapping of where the cases could be. And where the cases are, which means that if your community has zero reported cases, it may be because there isn't enough testing facilities. For myself, I even tried as early as Monday to ask the Research Institute for Tropical Medicine, the DOH, and the three other private hospitals to have myself voluntarily tested, just to see if I have the capacity to find out if I have, if I am, or if I am in danger. But all three institutions, well, all five institutions have declined, stating that there is no reason for me to have myself tested.
All right. Representative Nograles, we know so far, of course, you have confirmed that he is in fact an employee, the fatality, an employee of the House of Representatives, and that he is the eighth fatality reported by the Department of Health. Now, when was this employee diagnosed, and what department does he work for?
That is actually a huge mystery to many members of Congress, or the general employeeship of Congress, which is a source of concern because we're not so sure if contact tracing was even initiated by the officials. Right now, we're waiting for any instructions from the Secretariat or the leadership as to how to go about the fact that there is a fatality and there is a confirmed case. We don't know whether he went to work when he was diagnosed. We don't know exactly who he's exposed to. And I think the best thing that Congress, its visitors, and its workers can do at the moment is to self-assess for any symptoms, because our risk is much higher now than the general public, considering that Congress works within one single compound. So at this point in time, we really can't ascertain whether or not people have been exposed to the employee.
But you've mentioned that, in fact, employees can self-assess or make that self-assessment if, in fact, they have had some form of contact with the deceased weeks before he was diagnosed and weeks before he passed away. Will they at least be voluntarily quarantined, just to make sure?
I think there's a general call for self-quarantine at the moment, and the general sense right now is for us to help the government in fighting the disease. So I think the best practice, considering all factors considered, including the lack of testing kits, is to just stay at home, and everyone should self-quarantine. I think that's the best practice. And be alert for any symptoms and assess if these symptoms merit any visit to the hospital.
All right. This may be a good opportunity to conduct disinfection measures at the House of Representatives now that you're on recess. Is there any effort to do that?
I have heard that there are efforts right now conducting disinfection procedures throughout the House of Representatives. But regardless of these disinfection methods, the risk of exposure is still high. So I think we're just awaiting for official word from the Secretariat to instruct all members and employees as well as visitors on what's the proper protocol.
All right. On that note, thanks a lot, Mr. Congressman Jericho Nograles. Thanks a lot for talking
to
us.
Thank you, Stanley.